Hello, everyone. I'm Dr. Wang. Here is the question. If m and n both are integers, 2 times m squared plus n squared plus 3 times m plus n minus 1 equals 0, what are the values of m and n? This is a quadratic equation containing two variables, m and n. How to solve this kind of question? Here is the detail. We rewrite this given equation. We consider this equation as a quadratic equation about m only. M is an integer. This part, n squared plus n minus 1, can be considered as a constant. Because m is an integer, satisfy this equation, we have the following result. Its discriminant should be bigger than or equal to 0, and also it's a perfect square, because m is an integer. What are those numbers? B, A, C? The first number 2 is A. 3 is B. C equals n squared plus n minus 1. That equals b squared minus 4 times a times c. That must be bigger than or equal to 0, and is a perfect square. We derive data. Data equals 3 squared minus 4 times 2 times n squared plus n minus 1. We simplify the right-hand side. We have data equals 17 minus 8 times n plus 1. Data must be bigger than or equal to 0. It's a perfect square. The next thing we are going to do is to narrow down the search window for n. If n is bigger than or equal to 2, we want to check if this data satisfies this condition. Two conditions here, bigger than or equal to 0, and is a perfect square. We use inequality. N is bigger than or equal to 2, because here is minus, we should use less than or equal to. 17 minus 8 times 2 plus 1. We replace n by its lower bound, 2, here and here. We have these numbers here. Simplify, we have data less than zero. This means this condition is not satisfied. Therefore, n cannot be bigger than or equal to 2. This implies n less than or equal to 1. Let's check n less than or equal to negative 3. N plus 1 less than negative 3 plus 1 equals negative 2. This implies n plus 1 is also negative. Negative times negative is positive. We have this part. N times n plus 1 is bigger than or equal to negative 3 times negative 2, which is 6. Why here is big cell equal? Because the first number is negative. Second number is also negative. Negative times negative is positive. We should change the direction. Big cell equal. Let's calculate the data. Data equals 17 minus 8 times n times n plus 1. Here we have minus. This inequality should be less than or equal. 17 minus 8 times this 6. 6 is the lower bound for n times n plus 1. This number is negative. This means data is negative, which is not satisfy this condition. Therefore, n cannot be less than or equal to negative 3. This implies n must be bigger than or equal to negative 2. In conclusion, n is between negative 2 and 1. N has only 4 possible values: negative 2, negative 1, 0, and 1. We need to check one by one to see if they all satisfy the condition. If n equals 0, n equals negative 1. We can calculate data. Data equals 17 minus 8 times n plus 1. If n equals 0, this part equals 0. Data equals 17. If n equals negative 1, this part is 0. This means data equals 17. For both situations, data is not a perfect square. Therefore, n cannot be 0, and n cannot be negative 1. Let's check the other two values for n. N equals 1, or n equals negative 2. If we replace n here and here by 1, data equals 1 is a perfect square. If we replace n by negative 2 here and here, we also get the value. Data equals 1 again. 1 is a perfect square. Satisfy this condition. Now we are ready to calculate the value of n. By the quadratic formula, m equals 2 times a here's negative b plus minus square root of b squared minus 4ac. The inside part is theta. Continue to simplify this part. We have the possible values for m. M equals negative 1 and negative 1 half. From the given condition, m is an integer. M only can be negative 1, cannot be negative 1 half. For m equals negative 1, we have two values for n, n equals 1, or n equals negative 2. Therefore, we have two solution sets. M equals negative 1, n equals 1. M equals negative 1, n equals negative 2. That's all for today. Thanks for watching and see you next time.